Welcome to Inside Lake Forest. I'm Eileen Luby, your host, and today we're here to showcase Forest Park Beach, otherwise known as our Lake Forest Beach. Today I'm going to be meeting with a few of those people who bring you all the programs and activities here. It's one of the gems of our community. Hi, Sally. It's
Hi,
so great
Eileen.
To see you down here on this beautiful beach.
Well, welcome to Forest Park Beach. It's a wonderful place to be.
Thank you. And Sally Swarthout, who is program manager here. Sally, tell me a little bit of history about this beautiful lakefront.
Well, this beautiful lakefront came to be in 1987. The residents of Lake Forest voted on a referendum to actually renovate and rehabilitate this beach atmosphere. Mm-hmm. And this is what they have done. We now have 3/4 of a mile of absolutely beautiful landscape and beach.
It's absolutely gorgeous. I mean, everything from the pavilion, the marina, which I know you'll talk to me more about today and during this interview. Now, Sally, tell me what you think are the top 3 things about Lake Forest Beach and why residents should come down.
Residents should utilize this beach because it is one of the most spectacular parks that we have within the city. There is gorgeous sand, gorgeous water. It's a wonderful place to relax. We have incredible programming that goes down here, picnics to be had, volleyball games. It's just a fabulous place to spend time year round.
And why go anywhere else when you have this lakefront right here in Lake Forest?
Exactly. Why would you want to go anywhere else when you can just come here and see this beautiful view every day?
Sally, I understand that there are some new regulations so that the Lake Forest residents can better utilize the beach. Can you tell me about it?
Certainly, Eileen. We, after a year's worth of investigation and study, we have actually implemented some regulations that will be coming to each resident in the dialogue that's mailed to their home, mm-hmm. as well as can be found on the website, cityoflakeforest.com.
Okay, great. We'll have them check that out, and if they have any questions, they can contact yourself or the city.
Absolutely.
Sally, I know that the beach has also won an award. Can you tell me about that?
Certainly. Last year, we were the proud recipients of an award that honors the fact that we have done this beautiful renovation and been able to sustain the facility for over 20 years, causing no impact to Lake Michigan.
Now, Sally, you also want to tell me a little bit about the pavilions, because not only can you come out, have a picnic during the day, barbecue at night, or even possibly rent it out for a family get-together. Let's take a look and see those amenities.
I would be happy to show you our pavilions and all the things that you can do within them.
Sally, one of the best things about the beach is you can come out here at night and barbecue or during the day and picnic. What does the pavilion offer to our residents?
Well, we actually have 2 pavilions on the facility that you can rent. Mm-hmm. It offers you the amenities of picnic tables, a charcoal grill, fireplaces. We also have recycling units because we are a very green facility. So we encourage people to use those recycling, as well as utilizing and enjoying. And mm-hmm. you could actually find out information about renting a pavilion at cityoflakeforest.com or through the Recreation Center. I am the main contact. We have 1 pavilion on site, the North Pavilion, mm-hmm. which is located near the lifeguard office, which is actually a first come, first served basis. We never rent it. It's always open to the public. And we love people to actually come out here, utilize it, and enjoy great picnics with their families.
And there's several grills here, so you can share and work with other people here so that it's not just one that everyone's really trying to use at the same
time. Absolutely. Each of the pavilions has more than 1 charcoal grill. So it is a share type of facility, and we do encourage people to do that. It creates great community under 1 pavilion.
Well, the beach is for someone for all ages.
Absolutely.
A morning walk, an afternoon stroll, picnicking, barbecuing, or laying out, even swimming. And I know we'll talk to Ed in a little bit here and learn more about lifeguarding and the other facilities.
Wonderful. Well, welcome to Forest Park Beach.
Thank you, Sally. Sally mentioned not only can you barbecue, but you can picnic here. They also have a concession stand where it's the largest snow cones in Lake County. Let's check it out.
Hi, Eileen. Welcome to Cassandra's Concessions.
Nice to meet you, Edward.
Nice to meet you.
You are the lakefront supervisor here at Lake Forest Beach.
I am.
Now tell me about the concessions and what they offer.
Well, Cassandra's Concessions offers quite a variety of ice cream novelties and all kinds of popcorn snacks, hot dogs and hamburgers. And Willie and Cassandra will grill down on the south end on the weekends with a large grill. It's fresh, it's delicious.
So ice cream, chips, cookies, licorice ropes, largest snow cones, drinks, Gatorade water. you name it, you can find it down here at Lake Forest Beach.
Definitely.
And what are the hours of the concession?
10 to 5.
Okay, and that's Monday through Sunday?
That's every day of the week.
7 days a week, they are open.
Weather dependent.
Okay, yes. Okay, so if it's raining, it might not be open down here.
Correct, they might open a little later.
Great. Well, Edward, I'd love for you to talk to me more about lifeguarding and the safety that's provided here at the beach. So let's head there.
Okay.
Edward, I know here we are up on one of the lifeguard stands where the public is not allowed, so no climbing up here. But tell me about the lifeguards and their hours of operation.
Well, we staff the beach from Memorial Day to Labor Day, and we start at 10 o'clock and we go until 7 o'clock, and that's weather permitting. Sometimes we have red flag days and sometimes we have thunder and lightning. Even in the coldest of days, we're here, we're staffing the waters, making sure that the public is safe.
Wonderful. And in terms of other safety measures, what do you do here at the beach to take care of our residents?
Well, we try to enforce rules, and rules are pretty much just like with the police, it's just for people's safety. We try to keep people off the rocks because they are dangerous. They're very tempting, but we try to keep them off. We try to keep people away from our staff. We do have liability issues. If someone's up in the chair, someone might think that there's a lifeguard on duty, which in case may not be the
okay
case.
Okay. And how about the water? I see here we have our swim cast, a little action going on here in the beachfront.
Yeah, the swim cast is run by the Lake County Health Department, and what it does is a predictor model to see if the bacteria count is high, and it's dependent on the water temperature, the wind direction, the wind speed, precipitation, humidity. So there's a couple different factors that will predict whether it's a possible red flag day.
Okay, and so the Lake Forest Beach, how do you notify your residents if it's a red flag day? There's postings down here.
They can look at the entrances, and they can also call our information hotline. We were one of the first on Lake Michigan to have swim casts installed, and it is run by the Lake County Health Department, and it is a model for many communities. And so there are a couple on the North Shore, and it's something that we kind of tested, and it will sooner or later be a standard at most beaches.
Well, I think it's really important for the Lake Forest residents to know that here in the city, they've really been one of the first to implement this type of technology and how strongly they feel about the safety of swimming here at Lake Michigan.
Definitely. And you know, it's really important that people realize that this is a big beach, but it is extremely well covered by our staff and it is very safe.
Tell me about some of the other amenities here at the beach.
Well, we do have our wonderful playground and a very small area, what's called a spray ground, which is just basically a nice little fountain for kids to play in, maybe when we have red flag days. There's also plenty of shower towers that allow people to kind of clean themselves off of the sand. And also we have the beautiful harbor over there, or the basin, which we can launch power boats off of and sailboats. And it is pretty busy on the weekends.
Now, Edward, they also put up volleyball nets and things as well here, so people can come down and have pickup games.
We do have two sand volleyball courts, and they are, honestly, they're very premier as far as the sand quality and the nets. They are some of the best that I've seen in the North Shore, for sure.
Now, what are the beach hours of operation so people can be down here during the day?
Well, the police open up the gates at 6 a.m. and they close it at 11 p.m., and that's 365 days a year, weather dependent. If there's a lot of snow, we've got priorities to go ahead and remove snow in other areas, so they might not be open right away. But we staff it from 9 a.m. until 11 p.m.
Excellent. And for more information, they can obviously go on the city website as well as look in the dialogue, as Sally mentioned earlier.
That's correct.
Great. Well, Edward, it's been a pleasure meeting you today.
Very nice meeting you, Eileen.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What's been noted as one of the highlights here at the beach for some kids is what we call the echo chamber, where I'm standing here today. You stand in the middle here, out by the rocks, and as I talk to you, I can hear myself echoing. Many of the kids will yell things and will hear themselves and jump in joy and have a great time. I'm going to be meeting with Joey Harris, who oversees the sailing program here at the beach, as well as everything to do with the boat launch. Can't wait to meet him. Hi, Joey, it's nice to meet you.
Hey, nice to meet you too.
Joey Harris, who's sailing director at the Lake Forest Beach. Joey, tell me about the sailing program.
Well, we've got a lot of different programs that go on down during the summer. We've got programs for kids and adults. The kids programs run between the ages of 8 and 18. You have a bunch of different programs to choose from, either all day, half-day sessions. You can choose from two-week sessions or four-week sessions. And then our adult classes run in the evenings, typically from about 6 o'clock in the evening till about 8:30 in the evening. And again, those sort of run all throughout the summer. Facilities that we have actually rival pretty much any of the ones around the nation, not just in Chicago. So we're really lucky to have what we have to work with.
Fantastic. Now, Joey, also tell me about the boat basin and boat launching and how that works.
Sure. Residents can utilize the boat basin to launch small power boats or even sailboats if they you know wish to car top them if they don't want to leave them at the beach. So they can trailer them in, mm-hmm. launch them from our facilities. You can get a seasonal pass. Mm-hmm. And also, if you have a sailboat or a smaller boat, you can leave that either on the boat launch racks, again, for a seasonal fee, or okay. in the boat compound. And then we have hoists that that can launch the boats, so you don't have to trailer them in every day. The fees are really reasonable for residents for the whole entire season, and you can utilize it pretty much almost the whole time that the ice is off the water. So
fantastic.
People are going out early March, I should say mid-March, all the way through the end of November. So it's a pretty big season if you really want to avail yourself to it.
So Joey, tell me, the adult programs, are those offered at night and in certain length terms? Can you tell me more about it?
Sure. Most of the adult programs are going to start either on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and then we have one program that'll be all day or on Wednesdays, and they're all in the evenings from about 6 o'clock until 8:30.
Okay.
And so every 4 weeks, essentially, those will be starting anew. The youth programs, start during the day. Pretty much most of them will start at 9, and then they'll run through 3:30. Mm-hmm. We do have one class that is half day, so then you would start at 9, end at 12, and then start again at 1, and
okay.
finish at 4. But those classes also are either going to be 2 weeks or they'll be a 4 week class. So essentially every 2 weeks we'll have new classes starting.
And those, both the adult and children's classes, run from now through, tell me what the length of period so people can sign
sure.
up.
So the first classes are going to start June 15th.
Okay.
And then our last class ends August 21st.
Okay.
So it's a good 10 weeks of the summer that they'll
fantastic.
Be going on.
Fantastic. And so people really can sign up throughout the summer for their availability.
Yeah, generally we'll have a lot of kids sign up for the first session or so, and then they'll want to take another one, so they'll sign up for one later on in the season as well.
And for more information, they can always go to the city's website and
right.
look at the sailing program.
Right, if they go to lfrec.com and then click on activities and sailing, that'll take us right to our programs.
Perfect. Joey, tell me a little more about the availability of boat rentals at the beach.
Sure thing. Last year we started the program, and we've got a variety of equipment that people can come down and use. We've got double-handed kayaks, single-person kayaks. They're all sit on top, so that you don't have to worry about actually knowing a whole lot about kayaking.
Okay.
And then we also rent sailboards, and we've got two day sailors called 420s, which are two-person boats. And this year we're actually getting a Hobie Cat, so a catamaran that you can launch right off the beach as well.
Neat.
So it's a lot of fun. The rentals are available pretty much every day from 10 o'clock until 4.
Okay.
And they're first come, first serve, and a lot of people have a really great time with them.
Excellent. And again, for more information, they can find rental fees and things and contact you from the website.
Right. Absolutely.
Great. Well, Joey, it's been a pleasure meeting with you today.
You too, Eileen.
And good luck with the sailing program.
Yeah. Well, thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Thank you for watching Inside Lake Forest. For more information about all the amenities here, please go to the city website or call the Park and Recs Department. For fun in the sun, please come and visit Lake Forest Beach.